But it is a 3-mana elf that can kind of fill the same role as Aphidic Slime. The problem is I am counting on Slime to kill enchantments at the moment, so I'm not really sure that's going to work. This hand is pretty bad, but might be a keeper. It's going to go turn 2 Llanowar Elves, turn 3 Archdruid, and then turn 4 it'll have a big turn, and it's not even a guaranteed turn 5 kill. I just have to mulligan it. And that's awkward. I'm gonna mulligan again. And this hand is not good, but it's gonna have to cut it. I'm not sh I think the first hand was a mulligan, but it was relatively close. Certainly got punished for it. If we draw a land next turn, we are in fine shape. But if we don't, we are pretty much dead. So the next turn is definitely gonna be the key to this game. He did have a slow draw too. Yeah, that's not a very intimidating draw on his part. Llanowar Elves, so this is a bit of a fight between two awkward draws. We might actually be in okay shape. Next turn we can level the Tree Speaker, run our Copperhorn Scout into something, and then follow up with an Archdruid. So he's playing Chosen. Those are pretty weak in this matchup, as this matchup just kind of come down to comboing, I think. In this case, I'm gonna run the Copperhorn on a suicide mission. Copperhorn definitely does that a lot, but I think that's just an important role of the card. Like in this case, it was basically a Dark Ritual if you think about it. Which is a very reasonable role. So you have to be, when you play this deck, you have to be willing to make that play when it's correct. I think he's almost certainly Eldrazi Monumenting, since he seems to have Cobras, which is kind of a sign of Eldrazi Monument, and Nissa's Chosen, which is certainly a sign of Eldrazi Monument. Now the good news is next turn we're going to be able to Elvish Archdruid for Azuri, or to Green Sun Zenith for Azuri, excuse me, and then put some pressure on him, and we'll kill him in 2 turns pretty easily. I actually like our chances in this game, and actually in this matchup. We will be on the draw next game, which is a little awkward, but his deck is much slower than ours, just inherently. So, if we do some quick math here, the Green Sun Zenith for. Ooh, that's interesting. So, the Green Sun Zenith for Azuri will cost 4. Which means it could be just a tap of the Archdruid. And then we'll attack with the other three. That'll untap all lands, and we'll be able to activate Azuri's Overrun ability twice, which is pretty awesome. I don't know if he's dead this turn. At the very least, he might have to make a couple jump blocks. Oh, I'm so stupid. The Azuris will Legend Rule. That's my fault. Which is still good. But I'm just very dumb. I should have thought about that. I may have even made a different play. Eh, probably not. No, I would have still gotten Azuri, but I don't know why. I just wasn't thinking. Yeah, for what it's worth, I would have made the same play. Regardless, but it is kind of embarrassing that I didn't notice that. I'm not used to playing the mirror match, I'm used to being the only one slinging elves. His Nissa's Chosens are actually doing a reasonable amount of work here. Looks like he just wants to grind this game out slowly. The good news is that we have a lot of outs here that have just put him in a tough spot. Fauna Shaman being one of them, because now if we draw an elf, or if we draw any creature, which is, the majority of our deck, we can immediately get Azuri and kill him. And if we don't draw any creature, the only real other cards in our deck are Green Sun Zenith, which can get it, Leave the Stampede, which becomes a creature and lands. Oh, he has a second Azuri. That's gonna be a little awkward. So our next creature will just be get another Azuri to trade with his, and then the following creature will be the one that hopefully finishes him off. Now he has regeneration mana here, but I think we can take one hit for four without much of a problem. And that was huge. If we didn't hit a creature there, we were going to be in a bit of a tight spot. So at some point he should run out of Azuri since we have a way to tutor for them and he doesn't. Hopefully he won't just naturally draw all four of them. Now at this point, I'm not going to attack with Vengevine. I'd rather use my Vengevine to hold his Nissa's Chosen back, since, again, the longer this game goes, the better it is for us. I know I sound like a broken record, but it's the truth. So now he has a Fauna Shaman. So now we're in an interesting position where if I draw a creature this turn, I can put a lot of pressure on him. But if I don't, then we're going to be in this awkward situation. And there it is. So now it's thinking time. I'm going to Fauna Shaman for an Azuri for sure. That part's pretty simple. And then, let's see. If I play the Azuri tapping Archdruid, then I swing with three creatures, untap everything, and get to activate Overrun twice. So I'll be swinging for 8, 8, 8, 24 trample damage, which he can easily survive, but perhaps won't be able to survive easily. If on the other hand I use Tree Speaker to play the Azuri, I get 6, 12. I can attack with just the two creatures but get an extra overrun. So then I'll be overrunning three times, meaning it'll be 11 and 11 is only 22 trample damage. So it looks like the better line is to use Elvish Archdruid to play Azuri, even though it seems a bit counterintuitive. With the extra floating mana, I'm just going to regenerate my Copperhorn Scout and my Draugr Tree Speaker. Because hypothetically, he could make some sort of gang block and kill one of my guys, and I might as well make it the least desirable one that dies. I'm not going to attack with Vengevine here since I may need it on defense. I'm going to be tapping a pretty significant portion of my team. I'm going to be tapping the Archdruid, the Llanowar Elves, and the Tree Speaker on overrunning duty. So that's the only block he's making. I think he's dead. One would think that someone who played elves would know the math of the deck, but he's just going to take 16 from the two unblocked creatures, and he's taking a few trample extra. Yep, that'll do it. He had to block more aggressively there, and if he had, it wasn't clear the game was over. So yep, I'm still not going to sideboard, I don't think. I don't really want any of these cards, particularly. I could turn Vengevine into Tectonic Edge just so that, since Vengevine's so weak, I could just hit my land drops more consistently, but Vengevine does potentially do something. If we get into a game where Azuri start legend rolling each other, Vengevine could be the trump card, potentially. I could also bring in the 1 acidic slime since it's seeming more and more like he has monuments. But then again, that's pretty loose if it turns out he doesn't. I think it's worth the one slot, so I'm going to cut back one Vengevine for that. And I'm actually going to go ahead and cut two Vengevines for tech edges. I'll still have one Vengevine to tutor for if necessary. But